So what's the difference between white noise and pink noise? How do they relate to sound systems, music, and the way we humans perceive sound? Well, in this video, I'm answering all of these questions. But if you're new here, my name is Kyle. Welcome to Audio University. The simplest explanation that you might have already come across during your research is that white noise consists of equal energy per frequency, whereas pink noise consists of equal energy per octave. But you might be asking, what does that even mean? Well, let's take a look at these two signals on a frequency graph to get a better understanding. You can see that white noise forms a straight line from left to right, indicating that each frequency contains the same level of energy. Here's what white noise sounds like. Pink noise, on the other hand, forms a slanted line with more energy allocated to the lower frequencies. For this reason, pink noise sounds a bit darker than white noise. That's because there's equal energy per octave in pink noise. Remember, an octave is a doubling in frequency. Using a multiband compressor plugin, I'm able to listen to only the frequencies between two boundaries. When playing pink noise, the level is the same no matter which octave I listen to. It could be 400 Hz to 800 Hz, 2 kHz to 4 kHz, or 750 Hz to 1500 Hz. No matter which octave we listen to, the level is the same. When I play white noise, the level will be greater in the higher octaves because there's more energy concentrated in the higher octaves relative to the lower octaves. When I first learned this, it was explained to me this way. The octave between 1 kHz and 2 kHz is 1,000 Hz wide, whereas the octave between 8 kHz and 16 kHz is 8,000 Hz wide. This means that if energy were distributed equally to all frequencies, the higher octaves would contain more energy than the lower octaves. While this explanation is useful for understanding the difference between white noise and pink noise, it's important to remember that there are really infinite frequencies in all octaves when you consider the endless decimals between each whole number. As an audio engineer or music producer, I think it's most important that you understand why pink noise is especially relevant to human hearing and how it can be used in audio production and acoustics. Humans perceive frequency on a logarithmic scale, which makes pink noise the better choice for measurements and references related to human perception of sound. In Western music, there are 12 notes between 440 Hz and 880 Hz. There are also 12 notes between 880 Hz and 1760 Hz. We perceive these intervals as equal, even though the first interval is much smaller than the second when viewed on a linear scale. The bandwidth of the first octave is 440 Hz, while the bandwidth of the second higher octave is 880 Hz, even though the interval between these frequencies is one octave in both cases. This has a few implications that are important to us as audio engineers. First of all, it gives us an idea of what a well-balanced mix might look like on a frequency spectrum analyzer. If you try to mix for a frequency balance that is perfectly flat, it may end up sounding a bit thin. Instead, you'll probably find a frequency balance resembling pink noise to be much more pleasing. Of course, I'd ultimately recommend just using your ears to find a good balance based on the genre of music and your own personal taste. Secondly, when making acoustical measurements or tuning sound systems, you'll generally use pink noise. Our primary concern when making these tests is human perception. Take, for example, a sound isolation measurement. We generally care about perceived isolation more than absolute isolation. So we report transmission loss in third octaves, and because we report in third octaves, we use pink noise for a test signal. One question I had when researching to make this video for you is how are white noise and pink noise generated? A friend of mine who teaches acoustics and works as an acoustician put it this way. If you're generating the noise by moving something with mass, like water, you'll get equal energy per octave, which is pink. If you're generating a random event without the inconveniences of inertia, resistor noise, or flipping a coin, you'll get equal energy per possible outcome, which is white. Since white noise is trivial to generate electronically and computationally, artificial pink noise is usually white noise with a low pass filter. If you're interested in learning about a free software that you can use to measure your sound system, watch the video that's on your screen now to learn more.